Hey you guys, it's Michelle here. Thanks for joining me today and welcome to my channel. In today's video, I'm going to be doing my classic spread for next week, so stay tuned for a fun plan with me. Alright, for this spread, I pulled out the Plantything Plain Rainbow Pastel Boxes because I love these. And also the Wrong Wrong Pet Tapes. These are pre-cut. I'm going to use this one, which is like a spring floral one, and it's going to be so pretty with these boxes. So these are basically just like stickers on a roll. They're already cut. You don't have to cut them out like with some pet tapes. So I think those will be gorgeous with these. And I'll be sure to include my Plantything affiliate link in the description box as well as my Wrong Wrong link. And you can always use code Michelle10 to save 10% off on your Wrong Wrong purchase. And I always appreciate your support when you shop through those links at no extra cost to you. So, and I'll have to pull quotes from somewhere else, but let's see what I want to start with. We are actually going on vacation. On Sunday we fly out, so I want to have plenty of places to, you know, to have function. So let's start out with this box here, but I think I'm going to do this in the sidebar, just like that, and then I'm going to do this beautiful cluster right up here. Then I'm going to go ahead and put that on the side there, that scrap. Okay, beautiful already. And let's see, I want to do, let's do this one over here in the, like the bottom corner. And then I'm just going to use the rest of that to put right beside it. Oh, that looks so pretty. I think what I want to do is use some of these hexagons, but I also want to work some floral hexagons in. So I'm going to put a few of these on just some white sticker paper and then punch them with my 1.5 inch Fiskars hexagon punch. So I've just got some regular online label sticker paper, and I'm just going to put a few of these floral clusters on here and punch them right out of this. So let's do that one. I do want to stick with like these colors. I don't think I'm going to do much of the blue. Maybe this lighter blue, but not that really vibrant periwinkle. So let's do this one and this one. And another one of these. And then another one of these. Okay, let's get started with these. So now I have a floral hexagon. I'm gonna go ahead and do that to these and then I will be right back. I already cut this green hexagon. I'm gonna put that right here. And then I have my other floral hexagons. So I'm gonna kind of make a little tile pattern right here. Let's do this darker, like coral color. I'm going to put that right here. And then I have one of the ones I punched out. And put it right there. And then I've got this coral or like darker pink color. I'm gonna put right here, but I don't want it to extend past that line, so I'm just gonna trim that off. Then I'm gonna just get part of one right here. Let's do the yellow. So I'm just gonna trim off this part, and I'm gonna save all the scraps because they'll come in handy later. That right there, and then just trim off the excess. And then I'll do an orange one right here. Or part of one. So I'm just going to trim that off, even with this floral one. And I think I'll do another pink one there. And I've got part of a purple one I'm going to do here and let that cluster stop right there. I'm going to bring this up to that line. I just don't like how that stops abruptly like that. There we go. And I'm going to create something similar up here in this corner. Grab a bunch of these. Okay. So let's start out with this color. Just trim that side off where it's just going to be flush with this line. And then I'm going to use another one of these right up here. And let's do a yellow one here. Oh, let's do green. Right underneath it. Then I've got this scrap left over from this one that'll fit perfectly right here. And let's do yellow. this one. And I'm just going to trim these off right where they stop at that line. Okay. And let's also do... We need pink, this color. I'll do that one here. Let's do a little bit of the lavender one here. Actually, let's do that here, and then I'll probably put a word like to do or get it done or something there. I think I'm going to go ahead and extend this one a little further so they're not exactly alike. Let's do this yellow. Okay, so now let's go back to some like regular shape boxes. Let's do a green full box. Maybe not quite that big. Let's do one the next size down. Let's do this one and let's do that one here along with this smaller pink one. Or maybe I should do even smaller, like the slender one. Like this. Then up here, let's do the coral. Let's do this one. And the yellow and a slender one, what color would we need? Let's do the green. I'm going to go ahead and add some lines to this box. Okay, and for quotes, these are some that I hand lettered for spring. I'm going to use this larger Here Comes the Sun right over here, since that's when we're going on vacation. And this one that says spring is good for the soul, I'm going to use up here, I think. And let's use one right here that says, just bloom. I think I'll do it right here. Love today. Right up here. Okay, I think that's enough for quotes. Okay, and let's go ahead and add some more lines. I think maybe right here. And here and here, or maybe here. Let's see. So I want to add some lines right coming off of these hexagons. Okay, and let's also do some up here or here. Let's do these here. Let's do some right here. Even though we will be on vacation then, I can just journal about what we did that day or what we do that day. I think I'm going to switch this love today out for a larger quote now that I see it. Let's do life is sweet. And I think I want to add one more box here, since we don't really have much function on that day. So let's do a lavender, maybe this size, and then just turn it on its side. Instead of this way, we'll do it this way. Okay, now for bullet points, I'm going to use some of these scraps and just use the exact same colors and use my circle hole punch. All right, I got a bunch of bullet points punched out, and I'm going to go ahead and just save the ones I don't use in the back for future spreads. But I just did the green, the yellow, and the lavender. So let's do three here. We'll do green, and then yellow, and then lavender. Okay, and let's just do some right over here. And I'm just gonna use some of those scraps to put these in the back of this book. So I'll have them here for next time. I wanna add some more of maybe these flowers and butterflies. This roll, this particular roll of pet tape is called The Florist, and I'll be sure and have the link in the description box. And this one is called Spring Bloom. I'm gonna use some of these also. Okay, let's use like this ice cream cone. Oh, that's perfect. Up here by Life is Sweet. And I think I'll do two right there. And for Here Comes the Sun, around that, I want to do some of these cute little accessories, like this super cute little wicker bag. Oh, let's do these lavender heels down here. Oh, this is so fun. Let's do this pink dress over here by Just Bloom. And I think I wanted to add an angle. Actually, I think I'm going to move this over by the dress. Then I'll do the sunglasses here. Let's do this little butterfly. Right up here. And we'll do another one there. Oh, let's do this little hat. Do that right here. Now back to this set, the florist. Let's grab a couple flowers and drop those off. I'm going to cut this one right in the middle here, where nothing is touching, so I can use it two different places. And then I want to have it right here, I think. Maybe I don't like the ice cream cones. It's just a little bit too much going on. I'd rather do some flowers here. So I'm just going to put those right back on here. So I want to grab another one of these flowers. Or wait, here's a single flower and some leaves. Okay, that should be enough. Let's do that there, and one of these little palm leaves. And let's do this one up here. Those little scraps we'll do right up here. Let's do this little scrap right there. And that one there. Let's do another one of these right here. Let's have that little leaf coming from that one. And then this little palm leaf up here. Okay, let's scoot that over a little bit. I think I need some flowers over here for balance, but I could still write something there if I wanted to on part of the lines. So I'm gonna grab this same one over here and just turn it a different way. Just like that. I think I want one more butterfly, a smaller one, right there. Okay. And we'll have that there. And then let's go ahead and get some black words, and I think we're going to be done. Let's do today right here. And then down here, let's do something like get it done and cut it apart so it fits in that space nicely. Right here, let's do important, or to do. To do is shorter since it's right under a quote. I think I'm gonna put to buy over here. Because I need to pick up a few things for vacation, and then something else. Do don't forget right down here. And here let's do check it off. No, let's do write it down since I'll be on vacation then. You can do journaling or whatever. Okay, that is going to be my spread for next week. I love it so much. It's just so, makes me so happy to look at. I just love the combo, the colors, the little illustrations with these pretty pastel colors, everything about it. I'm so excited to write in it and plan in it. Thank you guys for hanging out with me while I put it together. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, don't forget to give it a thumbs up, and I can't wait to see you in the next video. Bye!